And welcome back to Let's Play, the final episode of Star Trek, Judgment Rites, Blind, or the final, well, my final bunch of episodes of this episode. Stepping into the portal.
Mr. Scott, they've disappeared off the sensors.
What do you mean, laddie?
They've just vanished.
Vanished? That's like the teaser intro. Yet there is method in it.
Captain's log, stardate 6269.3. The landing party and the Klingon Captain Klar have passed through a portal in time and space. We're about to face tests by the Brassica.
Yay.
Success will mean formal relations. Failure will mean unknown.
Death.
Welcome. We applaud your willingness to confront the unknown.
Golf clap.
Please tell us what's going on. Where are we?
Patience. I cannot answer all yet. Those elements of our society still ill at ease with your cultures have more questions.
We've had enough. No more foolish tests.
I don't want to choose this one.
More tests. Let's just get on with it.
More tests.
I'd like to hear what the others think. I'd like to hear what the others think.
Whoever are these others? This looks like some kind of insane globular green Furby or something. What do these others think?
I will withdraw until you address me again.
What? Come back, Furby. Alright, let's look around at stuff.
Dim colors swirl in all directions, so indistinct in form and pattern as to be unsure anything's there.
So we're in another dimension or something.
Dim colors. A quite alien-looking being.
Oh, yeah.
Its greenish skin hinting a plant phylogeny. Large eyes set well to either side of the head suggest a creature whose ancestors were more prey than predator.
Furby.
A third central eye augments 3D vision. A vibrating tympanum looking like an open mouth is the sound-producing organ. The brightly colored combs on its head might be personal adornment, rank significators, or tribal markings.
One never knows. Well, it's really
dim colors.
Nothing else to look here except for, you know, look at here except for each other.
The captain seems edgy, alert to danger.
Well, why would we be edgy? She should be perfectly comfortable here.
The doctor is queasy from the bizarre distortion of space around him.
Standing on these huge blocks. What are we in, like a Tetris game or something?
A Klingon, self-assured in his power, yet not arrogant. His expression is unreadable.
You should be a little taken aback as well.
The science officer is intrigued, but wary of an area which fails to conform to the precepts of Euclidean space.
Yeah, really. They're from beyond. It's the ancient ones. Cthulhu and really, yeah, or whatever. All of them. Yogg-Sothoth. Come back to destroy us all and make us slaves with their insanity.
The communications officer carefully controls her reactions and observes everything.
Very controlled.
The Brassica are calling the tune and expecting us to dance, Captain. It might be undignified, but all of us can make valid, responsible choices and stand by the consequences.
Captain, even though isolated, the Brassica are quite advanced. It's certain their insights will be unusual and enlightening. The logical course is to establish a dialogue.
We will do so.
If I was meeting us, I'd be skittish too. We've gone this far, there's no sense in quitting now.
I am grateful you included me, Captain. Representing the Klingon Empire, I believe we must not be cowed. Passivity may be regarded as undesirable to them.
Everyone all right?
Let's save.
Save new game.
What are we up to? 37, I believe.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete previous game. Save new game. Cancel. Delete previous game.
Let's delete a couple old ones.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete previous. Save new game.
I think we're on 37. Now, can we walk off? I can walk this way. I really can't walk. I really can't do much. Can we analyze stuff, actually? Yeah. What if we do this?
Jim, have you lost your mind?
No response. We're alone.
Yeah, we're not in the same dimension.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Seriously? Nothing unusual?
A sophisticated projected image similar to those on Onius 2.
So yeah, this is a projected image onto the block, so it's not really here, not much of a surprise, but... So he won't be able to see anything.
It's not a living thing, Jim. Right. Spock's tricorder is more useful here.
Wasn't very useful either.
Captain Kirk, I am here. Are you ready?
Our mandate is to seek out new life, new civilizations. If we must do so, on your terms, we will. Explain yourself. We're not rats to run mazes. We deserve to know what you want. We welcome contact with the new race, but you try our patience. No more tests or we'll leave. Now.
How the hell are we gonna leave?
Our mandate is to seek out new life, new civilizations. If we must do so, on your terms, we will.
Yeah, this is the best one.
Listen. We have modified our legends by what we understand of your species. You will be asked a question and may discuss it. Only one person may answer. Begin.
Oh. Hello?
I make the first query.
Danger.
Is that question posed to the heroic companions we call the Gerund?
What?
Answer this. Who among you may go to the greatest pains in the pursuit of life? You may talk. I will withdraw until you choose to speak with me. Remember, only one of you may reply.
I would think... Well... It's either the captain or the doctor. To preserve life.
It is impossible to read emotions from any of the Brassican's eyes.
Because it's closed, for one.
Dim colors swirl in all directions, so indistinct in form and pattern as to be unsure anything's there.
Well, we're standing on something, right?
Dim colors. One of the strangest projections you've ever seen.
Is it a projection?
The lieutenant seems to be in deep thought. One of the strangest projections.
That's a. Spock.
The Vulcan is fully engaged in analytical thought. The captain thinks about options the Brassica haven't anticipated.
Really?
The good doctor ruminates.
Ruminates!
The Klingon's eyes assess each person in turn, leaving a sense of judgment failed at every hand.
Leaving a sense of judgment failed? Our judgment or his own?
Alright,
so we need to talk about it amongst ourselves.
Gentlemen, I think you may be overlooking a fundamental difference between me and everyone else here. I am the only female, the only one capable of bringing forth new life.
True.
That qualifies me as the one among us who might go to the greatest pains in the pursuit of life.
I think it's the doctor.
The Brassican's question is not properly speaking a riddle. The riddle has a right and a wrong answer. This is more philosophical, with many possible answers.
Then how can we possibly answer correctly, Spock? Or can we?
one answer will seem more satisfactory than all others, Captain.
At least we can eliminate you, Spock, from this horse race. I don't see any right answer for you to be the person who would go to the greatest pain in the pursuit of life.
On the contrary, Doctor, respect for all living things is fundamental to Vulcan philosophy. A rigorous adherence, unlike humans' variable justifications.
You aren't suggesting, Spock, that you're the right choice.
I believe I may be, Doctor. The Brassicans may agree.
Well, science is the, for the betterment of life. Mankind, Vulcankind.
I believe I'm the obvious answer to this question. I'm a ship's captain. 430 lives depend on me. On my every decision. Our mission is, in part, to seek out new life, new civilizations. So it comes down to me.
Am I any different? Does not my crew live or die on my decisions? I explore space for the Klingon Empire!
A starship captain stands as representative of the United Federation of Planets. Many races, whose goals and visions for the future are pursued together. Who shoulders the greater weight, Captain Klar?
No one has ever accused you of modesty, Kirk. See it as you will. You, surrounded by your fellow humans and officers, or me, the sole representative of my empire.
Everyone's gonna think it's them. I think it's McCoy.
I am the right choice, Kirk, and I'm certain you understand why.
No. We don't understand crap.
I may not be Vulcan, but I'm the logical choice. Who goes through more pains in pursuit of life than a doctor? Jim, it's evident that each of us believes we're the right choice. I'm reasonably sure I'm the person they have in mind. But I can see everyone can make a case for themselves.
As indeed we have, Doctor.
I fail to see how further discussion will alter the situation. Either you must come to some decision, weighing the strength of individual opinions.
Or I get some hints out of our green host.
Can we get hints from him? I want to do this.
Save new game replace.
We have our answer. Are you ready to hear it? We have questions to ask. We have our answer. We have questions to ask.
Questions.
Very well. Ask.
What consequences result from an incorrect answer?
Very good question.
What if I were to declare that there's not one right answer, but many? Would you please repeat the question? We can't answer because we don't know enough about your species. Tell us about yourselves. If we understand more, we can answer. What consequences result from an incorrect answer?
Yeah, I really want to know this.
The overall test will likely continue, Captain. This is one phase, and we are examining the whole.
What if I were to declare that there's not one right answer, but many? We can't answer because we don't know enough of... What if I were to declare that there's not one right answer, but...
There is just one answer we would consider wholly correct, Captain Kirk.
In reality, you expect us to answer two questions. What we think is right, and what you think is right. We're ready with our answer. In reality, you expect us... What consequences result from an incorrect answer? You are clearly a race who values fairness.
Oh, I didn't even answer that.
Shouldn't we have more information before we try to answer?
It just flipped to different questions when I chose that.
What consequences... You are clearly a race who values fairness. Shouldn't we have more... What consequences result from an incorrect answer? You are clear...
Very well.
No. It was agreed they shouldn't be given special assistance.
Who that?
Their complaint is valid. Different species think differently. A hint seems appropriate.
They must show the faculties to think through problems.
Well, Captain, are you positive you want a hint?
Yes, get on with it. No, don't bother. We'll give our answer now. Yes, no, don't bother. We'll give our answer now.
To pacify these others, we'll give our answer.
Let the one who would answer be the next one to talk.
I've said it all, Jim.
We have our answer. Are you ready to hear it? We have questions to ask. We have our answer. Are you ready to hear it?
Let the one who would answer be the next one to talk.
I've said it all, Jim.
I'm trying to... Yeah.
My whole life has been dedicated to the preservation of the lives of those around me. To make the quality of that life as high as possible. In short, I think I'm the one who goes to the greatest pains in the pursuit of life.
Your answer is accepted. However, this is not to say whether this answer is right or wrong.
Hey, tell me.
Where's he gone?
The next question awaits, Captain Kirk.
Where's our doctor, damn it?
You are nothing like the Gerund, who hold a special place in our memories. The second question.
Gerund.
Who among you wrestles most intensely with the chaos of life? Talk amongst yourselves. I will answer questions if I can. In the end, only one may reply.
Poor her over here by herself. I would think that Spock, since, illogical things frustrate and confound him to no end. So I would choose Spock in that case.
It is impossible. Emotions are not apparent, but clearly his mind is racing. Captain Kirk looks ready to explode with intensity. The Klingon is paying very close attention to all that occurs.
Quick, watch Kirk explode with intensity.
The lieutenant is alert yet cautious.
And all this crap is just...
Dim colors swirl.
Yep.
Captain, I believe my profession makes me the one to answer. Intelligent life only thrives through communication. I struggle to ensure understanding between the variety of species. Without that understanding, it would be sheer chaos.
She's got a point.
It's obvious you have never spent time among Klingons, Kirk. The life of the Klingon warrior is the struggle between control and chaos.
Controlled chaos is how you describe it, Klar? I'm surprised.
Clearly, the Brassica know more of us than you. And I am certainly the one who these aliens intend to answer. My lineage extols the tradition of Kalas.
My reasons for selecting myself are at least as good as yours, Klar. I recognize your position, Klar, and if you thought the same as me, I'd have second thoughts. But I don't. As captain of the Enterprise, I'm responsible for the lives of everyone on board. Without a strong hand at the tiller, it would be complete chaos. Those demands make me the best answer.
It's actually... I find it quite contrived that every member thinks that they're the answer.
As with the previous question, this is a question of judgment, Captain.
Meaning there's no right or wrong answer.
I suspect the Brassica would disagree with you, Captain. There is likely a specific answer they expect. I can only speculate.
And?
Each of us can best make his or her own case. As science officer, I believe myself likely. It is the very heart of science to attempt to comprehend the fundamentally chaotic nature of the universe.
Now that he puts it that way. He didn't even mention his emotions and logic. I think in this case, Kirk makes a better case.
We are ready with our answer now. We have questions. We have questions.
Very well. Ask.
What did you do with my crewman? Give me an explanation.
Yeah.
Would you define some of the words you're using to give us a better idea what point you're trying to make? We've answered one question. We're trying to meet you halfway. Will you tell us something about your people now? With questions like we've had, any two people can come up with a different answer. How do you judge which is right and which is wrong? Please repeat the original question. What did you do with my crewman? Give me an explanation.
We will not discuss this.
This encounter is over. You've given me no reason to trust you. I won't sit by and let you spirit my people away. I don't like it, but I'll take it, for now. I'll expect an explanation before this is over. And this encounter... I don't like it, but we are ready with our answer now. I want to question you further. Would you define some of the words you're using to give us a better idea what point you're trying to make?
Yeah, this one.
Define words?
I am not one who thinks you should have any assistance.
Others among us are less hostile, Captain. Perhaps a broad hint, something less definite than the words.
Define the words? We communicate clearly. Without ambiguity, it would not be a riddle.
Would you at least explain the context of the words?
You are not making a good impression on my associates, Captain Kirk, as I anticipated. What is it you want to find?
Explain your use of chaos in this context.
Yeah, that's a valid question.
Explain your use of life in this context. Explain the phrase wrestles most intensely. Forget I asked. Let's get on with something. Explain your use of chaos in this context.
Chaos, Captain Kirk, is the way intellectually sophisticated races understand complex patterns which seem to be random, but are not. The shape of a cloud, unpredictable and changeable, but nevertheless comprehensible. What else do you want to explain?
Explain your use of chaos in this context.
Now I'm starting to think it could be Uhura.
Explain your use of life in this context. Explain the phrase wrestles most intensely.
How disappointing, Captain.
Oh, God.
I, of course, expected nothing better.
Shut up, Major Barrett.
This part of the question addresses the dichotomy of life and death, and the eternal struggle between those grand concepts.
What else do you want to explain?
Explain your use of chaos. That's enough for now.
I'm thinking Kirk.
We are ready with our answer now. We have questions. We are ready with our answer now.
Let the one who would answer be the next to speak. I think you'll want to discuss this, and then you may address me again when you are better prepared to answer.
Okay, we need to discuss more.
Comprehending chaos is more work than one lifetime. That is the reason I believe I am the answer to who wrestles most intensely with the chaos of life.
Maybe my initial feeling was, you know, the right one.
I think I'm the one who should answer. I'm still open to differing opinions, so let me hear them.
Apparently it's not Kirk.
The course of my life as a Klingon of repute is proof I am the one to answer.
As I said, communication, an intrinsic expression of intelligent life, is my profession. I am the one who wrestles most intensely with the chaos of life.
It's either her or him. I got you, Spock.
It is the heart of science to seek an understanding of the universe and its laws, to make sense of what seems randomly chaotic. In the effort to extract comprehension from the unknown, I work to recognize the underlying patterns for which life represents the greatest challenge. Thus, I am the one among us who wrestles most intensely with chaos.
You have answered two of our questions incorrectly.
What?
This indicates to us that you are too different from us. We shall attempt this again some other time. You shall all be returned to your ship.
Okay, it's her then. Well, that was disappointing. We need to go back.
We're back on the Enterprise.
It feels like we've been dreaming.
It is logical to assume we shared the same experience. Unless the Brassica have psionic abilities they did not demonstrate.
Captain Kirk, I grieve to say that your answers were beyond our ability to tolerate.
Oh, sheesh.
We had hoped for better from your species.
You should not judge any species from just one sample.
The captain is correct. It would be most illogical to make a decision based on such limited data.
Is broad enough. In the future, perhaps our species might form a bond of friendship. But for now, we must remain apart. Farewell.
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
I reviewed your report from your recent assignment, Captain, and have a few comments. I'll be frank, Kirk. Starfleet expects more out of you than that. If I were you, I'd do some serious soul-searching about my command ability. I would expect as much from a cadet, but from Starfleet's finest. I'm going to have to forward my concerns to command. Kane out.
Another message from Starfleet.
On screen.
Jim, we have evaluated your current series of missions. I hate to say it, but you're lucky you've done as well as you have. We found numerous lapses of judgment.
Oh my God.
I expected better.
Yes, Admiral.
When this mission is over, we should schedule some time for a refresher course. The Academy Simulator isn't just for cadets, you know.
I agree, Admiral.
That's all, Jim. Starfleet out.
I wonder what he'd say if he were in the command chair.
He's right, Bones. The moment Starfleet standards start to slip is the moment the Federation is in trouble.
Agreed, Captain. Triumphs achieved without an adequate standard are hollow and meaningless.
I suppose we could have done better.
And we shall, Bones. We shall.
Yeah, I'm definitely reloading. Okay, so try again. I'm gonna have McCoy answer the first one.
My whole life has been dedicated to the preservation of the life.
Your answer is accepted. However, this is not to say whether this answer is right or wrong.
Where's he gone?
The next question awaits, Captain Kirk. You're nothing like the Gerund. Hold a special place in our memories. The second question.
Does that mean we failed it? Wait, hold on. Oops, sorry about that.
Alone among the people here, I am female and capable of childbearing. The nurturing of a new life remains a uniquely female labor. Certainly, I am the one among us who might go to the greatest pains in the pursuit of life.
Your answer is accepted. However, this is not to say whether this answer is right or wrong.
Where's he gone?
The next question awaits.
Where's she gone?
You're nothing like the Gerund. Hold a special place in our memories.
Still say it.
The second.
Jim, I can't help feeling this question is directed at me. I can't explain exactly. Let me think about it a bit.
Okay.
It's obvious! You have never spent...
I recognize your position, Clara, and if you thought... As captain of the Enterprise, I'm responsible for the lives of everyone on board.
It's definitely not Kirk.
As with the previous question, this is a question of judgment, Captain.
Meaning there's no right or wrong answer.
I suspect the Brassica...
And?
Each of us can best make his or her own
chaotic. If the universe wasn't ordered, we couldn't make sense of it, Spock.
As you are certainly aware, Doctor, chaos defines the very nature of patterns. However, this does not mean random.
Well, that may be. On the other hand, I would be the last person to say a Vulcan wrestles with any concept. And don't you raise your eyebrow at me, Spock.
Huh.
Just give me a minute. You broke my train of thought. Just give me a minute. You broke...
Save new game.
Well, this pertains to question two.
We are ready with our answer now. We have questions. We are ready with our We have questions.
Very well. Ask.
What have you done with Lieutenant Uhura? I demand an explanation. Would you define some
Didn't
of the
work
words
last
you're
time.
Using to give us a better idea what point you're trying to make? We've answered one question. We're trying to meet you halfway. With questions like we've had, any two people can come up with a different answer. How do you judge which is right and which is wrong?
How do you know right from wrong, Captain?
That is my question, and you're not answering.
Huh.
How would you? For us, it is experience, mediated with tradition. That is my question, and you're not answering.
Actually, I did provide the path to understanding. A civilized race would answer a question with a more probing question.
What gives you that idea? Let's just get back to the point. How would you react if you encountered a race you considered civilized, but didn't behave just the way you expected?
That's a good point.
What gives you that idea?
A weak question, Kirk. Your unworthiness is clear to me.
We are ready with our answer now.
Cry me a river, lady.
I want to question you further. I want to talk with my associates. We'll get back. What might we do to improve your opinion of us? We are ready with... What might we do to... I want to talk with my associates.
Just give me a minute. You brought...
All right, so what if it is him?
I am a physician. I am the one who cares for life and health of hundreds aboard the Enterprise. The patterns of chaos are the patterns of life and death, and every day of my professional life is focused on balancing those patterns towards sustaining the quality of life. I am the one among us who struggles most intensely with the chaos of life.
Glad you figured it out.
Your answer is accepted, Dr. McCoy. However, this is not to say whether this answer is right or wrong in our sight.
You expect me to stand by while my people keep disappearing?
The next question awaits, Captain Kirk.
Yeah, thanks for ignoring us. Oh, sheesh, are these spheres now?